as a public information system. Last class also I asked you a question, why should I inform, why should I study this information system? Because I should study, because I always get informed by someone. I always get informed by someone, means by means of a phone, by means of a mail, by means of a TV, by means of any electronic device or something, like by means of your wearable device. You are wearing your wearable devices, like your MI device or something like that. So that give you information. So that sends your information, that takes information from your using a sensor from your body, and that displaying the information to you, that this is your heart rate, this is your number of steps you have traveled today. So these are the informations. Okay. Ayush Kumar Vada Jain. Okay, so I'm starting the new topic today. Oh, and this I have discussed, like what are the managerial applications, informations, jobs presently available inside the market. Okay. Then today I am going to start with the information systems, or popularly known as IS, that function among multiple organizations. How inside an organization, or inside between two organizations, how information system can act as a medium to communicate. Okay. So you have people have studied the e-commerce. People, you have studied about the business. You have understood about the business. Business is nothing but, what is the definition of business? Business system is a combination of policies, personal equipment, and computer facility to coordinate the activities of business organization. So these are the personal equipment and policy combined, and with the help of computer facility to do some activity, is nothing is called the business. And if it is done inside the business organization, it is called business organization. So now there are different types of business, like B2B, B2C, C2C, or these things. B2B means business to business. That means one business is doing with another type of business. One business organization is doing business with another business organization, that is called business to business. Okay. Business to customer. Like you, Flipkart is a business and you are a customer. So Flipkart is doing business with a customer. So that is called business to customer. Okay, now business to customer. So you are, like when you are going to buy vegetable in your local market, people are selling vegetables. That is also, they are buying vegetables from there somewhere else, and they are selling to you. So that is customer to customer. They are doing business customer to customer. So there is no organization in a vegetable market. Okay. When people are selling vegetables over there, there is no organization, but they are doing also business. So that business is called customer to customer business. Am I clear?
Yes,
am I clear? Please respond. Students, please respond. Am I clear? If you don't have, if you have doubt, please ask.
Sir, please explain again.
Okay. Tell me. What I am saying, there are different types of custom business is executing. You are doing business in online, that is called e-commerce business. Okay. One great example is, your people are purchasing elements from Amazon, Flipkart, all these things. So Amazon is doing business with whom? Amazon is one sort of, when you are purchasing a product, you are a client for the either Amazon or a Flipkart. Okay. So Amazon is doing business. You are buying business is means what? You are doing some transaction. So the transaction, you are sending the, you are purchasing the money with paying some amount, and they are sending in regard to that amount, they are sending the product. So what I'm saying here, that sort of business like Flipkart, Amazon, Myntra, this all the online shopping, they are doing business to customer. This e-commerce business is for business to customer. So you are the customer. They are having a business organization. They are running a business organization. They are doing business with you. So that is business to customer. Now there is another type of business is there, that is business to business. Like, very good example is very good example is there is no meaning of customers are there. They are only doing the business to business. Like if I can say import and export. Okay, so you have a product, and you want to deliver somewhere else. But you cannot do some delivery directly to outside. So you need a organization who is doing the export business. So you have given, like, just a small example I am saying. You are delivering a courier. A small example. You are trying to send a document or product to through a medium of a courier. So consider you are trying to, your DTDC is, you know, DTDC is a courier company or having a business which is local to you. Okay, so you have given them the document and pay the product amount, the charge or the service charge. So what DTDC is doing, DTDC is trying to identify a business, nearby business. First, they are trying to identify whether any that particular address is having any DTDC organization or not. Okay, if that is existing, they are giving the information or giving this business to them. So I am giving this organization, a DTDC nearby your location is giving the information to DTDC to the destination address location. Okay, now, so this is a one business, local business, DTDC, and they are also having a local business at the destination end. So you are at the source end and they are at the destination end. So you are doing the business. You are not doing the business. You pay the amount. They are doing the business. The business is, they are giving that amount and they are accepting that things. In regard, they will acknowledge them. Okay, we have received your product. And they will deliver at the location. Now, okay, there is one more thing. That if DTDC is not available at the destination location, suppose, okay, what it will happen? Will your product not be delivered? Your product will be delivered. But by whom? By a different company. Suppose Blue Dart. DTDC is not available at the destination end. So Blue Dart is available. So what DTDC will try? DTDC will try to establish a business between Blue Dart at the destination end. So he will say that please deliver my product to the client, destination client. We will pay you the amount. So from the amount which you have paid at the source end, they will pay the same amount to the Blue Dart. Okay, once Blue Dart receive the amount and the product, they will do the delivery. So this sort of business is, this is a business organization. DTDC is a business organization. Blue Dart is a business organization. They are doing the business. So this is called business to business. You are not involved in between them. They are doing business among them. So among Flipkart, when you are buying, that is business to customer. So this is an example of business to business. Now, when I have given a good example, when you are going to a local market, purchasing a vegetable, you are buying from a vegetable shop. Okay, the shopkeeper selling you the amount. So he is also a customer. He don't have any organization. He's not running any business or business organization, but he is doing the business. He is also a customer. He buys products from somewhere else and he is selling to you. You are also a customer. So that is a customer to customer. Now am I clear?
Yes, sir.
Now am I clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Students, it's a request. If in any slide, at any point of time, if you are unable to understand any concept, please stop me and ask questions. Okay. Now, as I have discussed, we are going to discuss about the business information system inside a multiple organization. So this is a B2B business organization, that is electronic commerce, e-commerce. Electronic commerce is nothing but e-commerce. So this e-commerce company is sending the material to the supply chain management. As a supply chain management means what? The delivery things. Because Amazon is associated with some delivery partners. Amazon has its own delivery partner company, but it due to the large size of due to the large business size, they are associating with the some delivery partners. Maybe delivery, maybe Blue Dart, maybe DTDC, maybe some courier company. So that is, they are doing the supply chain management. So this is an supply chain management organization. This is an Amazon, suppose consider B2B. So they are doing some material transactions. So their product, your product is given by them. Now this is the material. So this is a business to business. So they are doing information. What they are giving the payments. So your organization is giving the payments. Your organization is giving the online order. And this information is delivered to the supply chain management. Now you have done these things because you have payment. You are here. You have given the payment. You are posting an online order. So this supply chain management role is to deliver the physically product. So this material which they have collected from here, from the supply chain organization. So they will deliver to you at your end. Now this business to business is same. So if I this concept is clear, everyone. How this product you are putting an online order. Simultaneously, you are giving a payment from your UPI, from your credit card, some transaction you are doing. So that this is a digital confirmation. Digital product means what is digital product? Digital product is nothing but when you are purchasing something in the purchasing amount, once it is purchased, you are getting an acknowledgement in your cart. So that means this item has been purchased by you. It is showing in your order list, your purchase order list. Now, but it is not physically available. So how it will be available? Because you have put an order. It is showing that your product will be delivered within 10 days. So who will be delivered? Your supply chain management is cost. See, you are doing the relationship with the customer relationship manager. So your customer relationship manager, suppose here it is a Flipkart. Customer relationship manager is there. So customer relationship manager who give this information, your order, your payment information, everything to the company. Suppose it is Flipkart warehouse is there. So they are giving this information to the warehouse. And the warehouse system is giving the product to the supply chain management section. This supply chain management section is delivering the physical product to you after the stipulated amount of time. Now it is understood. And these everything is executing by means of internet, because without any internet system, your information will not be getting delivered to them, and they also will not able to pass the same information to the warehouse system. Am I clear? Students, am I clear?
Yes, sir.
Others, please respond. Arpita, Ayush, Bhavesh, Gaurav.
Yes, sir.
Understood or not?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now in an organization, what it looks like an organizational information system. In an organizational information system, there are different systems are there. So when they have these systems have specific functions, like this functional area information system. So what it is doing, it supports the activities within the specific functional area. Example is system for processing payroll. Okay, transaction processing system. We will discuss this transaction processing system later on. So what it is doing, it processes the transaction data from business events. Like when you are purchasing, you are doing some transaction, or when you are doing online payment, or when you are sending your money through a medium, we are doing some transaction. So there is a processing system is existed inside things that is called transaction processing system, like a Walmart checkout point of sale termination, like everyone doing some online purchase. Everyone is doing online shopping.
Yes, sir.
Everyone who is not doing online.
Yes,
shopping.
Sir.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Everyone. So everyone has a little bit idea. We will discuss in here, like you are giving and going to a website. There is an information given to you, and this information going entering into the website is by means of an internet. You are entering in with the help of internet into an information system. That suppose this is a Flipkart, it's an information system, and you are objective is to purchase a TV or a mobile, your mobile handset. Again, Flipkart is showing information like different mobiles are there, different specifications are there, which specification you are preferring. Suppose your budget is 5,000. and you have a such and such specification. You are going clicking that I want, my limitation is 5000 and these are my specific, like I have need a 2 GB RAM processor and the like internal memory is 8 GB memory. So all these things are your objective. When you put this information, you are doing it again. Flipkart is showing this, these are the selected informations from the warehouse informations, like selected information which meets your requirement, which meets your requirement. Now when your meted requirements is visible, are you going to purchase all? Suppose Samsung is having the same specification like 5000 and same specification what you required. Suppose MI is having the same specification 5000 and all these things. Suppose Nokia is having the same specification. Are you going to purchase all? No, you are purchasing only one. Yes or no? You are purchasing only one mobile phone. So there is also some preference issue is there. So you are giving a priority over suppose a Nokia over Samsung or MI or something like that. You purchase that mobile. How you purchase? Once you select it, the item is placed inside your order list. First you have to add that system into your order list. Once the item is added into your order list, you are doing now allowed to do the transaction. When you do start initiate the transaction, the information is required. What information? Like your information about your name, information about your where the product is going to be delivered, information about your the pin note, pin code, everything. Whether they again they will check whether that product will be getting delivered to your end or not by means of your pin number. So when you enter your pin number, they will show you, okay, your product will be delivered within such and such day, like suppose 4 days or 1 day or 5 day or 10 days, something that. If your pin is undelivered, that means there is no business is there inside your locality, nearby your locality. So it is showing a message that this product cannot be delivered at your end. That means there is no chance of buying that product. So you are choosing an alternative product. So what happens when you are if suppose the product is delivered at your end after that, then only they are asking to allow to do the transaction. Once you are allowing to do the transaction information system is requesting some information again. What information? Your credit card information, your debit card information, or you are doing online information, online banking information. You are putting your online banking information over there. Now, once your online information is over there, once it will ask you, that information will send you a encrypted message. Encrypted message means what? A security key. Like your bank will give you a security key, or your credit card will give you a security key, whatever may be. So they will give you a security code. Once you enter the security code, your product will be now in the phase of purchase. Once the purchase has been done, the transaction system is completed. Once the transaction system is completed, the item is showing in your order list is purchased. The item is showing is in the list of purchase, but now item is not delivered. It will be delivered after such and such time. So this is a transaction processing system. Am I clear?
Yes, sir.
Am I clear? Clear? Okay. Tell me. Any doubt? Now, enterprise resource planning. It integrates all functional areas of the organization. Functional area. Every organization has some functional part. Functional means like your meal is inside a mill, rice processing mill. So there is a system, there is a machine. Okay, so that is, but there is not a single machine. So there are multiple machines. Suppose one machine's output is giving as an input to the other machine and another for that processing of that product. So pre-processing, some post-processing, and finally the packaging. So these all the functions, I'm giving an example. So these all the functions. So if this is one system, like first raw material collection, then processing, then packaging. So these are three different systems. These are three different functions. when you integrate these three different functions as a whole, that is called enterprise resource planning. Enterprise resource planning. So this is I am giving in a terms of a mill. But here inside a computer, you can't do things how you are doing things, like a bunch of people are designing a architecture of a product, of a project. A bunch of a people who have a role that designing. Okay, so they are designing the product. Now some people are coding, so they are coding that part. Some people are there for validation. They are doing the testing. So people are there for testing. So they are testing functionality, coding functionality, design functionality. Finally, deployment, delivery. So they are doing the delivery. They are responsible whether any query is coming from the client, they have to respond. So they cannot be respond directly. They will again communicate with you. So this is a different functionality. When they are coming combined together, that is called enterprise resource planning. Now, office automation system, it supports daily work activities of individuals and groups. So office automation system, suppose you are entering inside office. For first thing, what you will do, you have to swap your ID card. You have to swap your ID card in a biometric, that your time starts inside the organization. You are entering with your biometric ID card. So biometric ID card, what it is doing, it identify from the biometric informations, it matches with your database. Now, whether this employee is your organization employee. Okay, if yes, then it allows you to inside the office. Now, from that, your working hours is calculated. Now, your working hours is suppose 5 hours. You entered at 10 o'clock. So after 5 hours, like after 5 hours from 10 o'clock, you are able to leave that organization. So when you are leaving the organization, you are again doing the swapping with your ID card. So once you are swapping the ID card, it will check whether how many working hours you have actually serviced inside the organization. Once it, if it matches with the minimum requirement time, then it allows you. Okay, suppose this information are stored somewhere. Now, who is processing your salary? Who is processing your salary inside an organization? He has all the informations, like when you enter, when you exit, on which day, which month, which year. Based upon that, your salary is evaluated. Suppose you have suppose only service for a particular day, only 2 hours. Now you have left the company. Now in that database, it will be shown that you have serviced, suppose Tuesday, you have serviced from 10 o'clock to 12 o'clock. Okay, so you are allowed to take a leave or your salary will be deducted. So these are the daily information systems. Daily you are purchasing office information system. This is called office automation systems. Like whether it is related with any individual or it can be related with the group. In computer, how it can be done? You people are using a Microsoft Office. In Microsoft Office, you are opening a document. Today, you are opening a document today, you are writing something like that, and you are saving that things today. Tomorrow, again, you are coming and you are opening that document. If you write something, you need to save. If you won't save your current informations, whatever the things you have added, it will not be saved. But it is showing that previous day's information, because in previous last day, you have saved the information. So these are the everyday information. So these are the office automation tools. That's why it is called office automation tools. Microsoft is launched an office automation tools. Automatically it required, but it needs to be saved for every day. End of the every day, your work has to be saved so that you can reflect in the subsequent day. Now, management information system. The product reports summarized from transaction data, usually in one functional area. It report on total sale for each customer. From that management information system, when you purchase some product, so that product information must have to be delivered to the manager. Whether product manager, what is the role of a product manager? The product manager has to be taken care of about what are the feedbacks the customers are giving about that particular product and what are the requirement or demand of that product among the customers. So this regarding the sale of the product or sale report of a customer is managed by this management information system. okay, this system, management information system, is managed by the manager, office manager. So decision support system. So decision support system means their work is to take some decision. So there are companies, there are companies where there is an organization which called, which is allowed to do some decision. Like suppose when you are launching a product, you are launching a product with keeping your requirement of the client. Now suppose I am a decision team. Now I have to think, what if it will happen if my product will be not matched with the customer? Suppose bunch of customers, suppose 100 customers are requiring one product. Suppose if I am designing a product for to within eyeing of a matching the requirements of a 100 customer, what if only 10 customer satisfied with my product? I have to think in like that way. So who will think that thing? That thing will be discussed, that thing will be discussed inside a decision support system. So what they are doing, what is the role, what if analysis of changes in a budget, whether that budget has to be considered a constraint, whether the product specification is a constraint, whether what is the constraint. So this thing is managed by the decision support system. Expert system, what they are doing, the credit card approval system. Like suppose when you are doing the transaction, okay, when you are doing the transaction, so that information is stored somewhere. You are giving your information to that transaction processing system company. So now their expert system match with this information to your database already listed. Your credit card information is stored somewhere. So they are now matching. Once that is matched, whether you are this card number is held by this employee or not, if it is matched, then they will send you a security key to your M number. Your number, which has been registered with that particular credit card. Now, so this has been done by some expert system. Executive dashboard, status of sales by product. So there is a sales team is there, whose role is how to structurally deliver the product. Okay. And they are collecting the sales information every day sales information. How many of products are going from warehouse to that supply chain section? And what are the supply chain demands over there? And what are the daily day purchasing transaction is there? So there is a executive dashboard. Now comes to the supply chain management system. What they are doing? They work manages the flow of the product. Flow of the product from where? Flow of the product from the warehouse team to the client team or the customer team. Electronic commerce system. This is the media. Enables the transaction among organization and between organization and a customer. Very good example is you are purchasing a laptop from a Dell, or where you are purchasing from a product from Make My Tree, when you are purchasing product from Amazon. So this is a called an e-commerce system. Any transaction or any business by means of a internet to do the things, that is called an e-business. E-business means we are doing transaction or e-commerce system. Am I clear? So these are the organizational information system. Any doubt? Students, any doubt?
No, sir.
Okay.
No, sir.
Okay. Now, next slide. So business intelligence system. So what is business intelligence system? Because everything is done by means of internet. So there is an IT components are there. What are the IT components? Information technology components. Because that your Wi-Fi device, your LAN device, your router, your switch, these all are the information technology components. Now, these are who is running this based upon some engineers, IT engineers is running these informations. So these engineers are giving services. These engineers are giving services to whom? To a system. To a system. To what system? They are transacting. So this entire information is called the IT infrastructure. IT infrastructure, IT component, IT personnel, or nothing but the engineer, or IT services. So this consists of IT infrastructure. So now they are doing the transaction processing system. In the transaction processing system, as I have discussed, there is doing some transaction. So what information? Your accounting information system, finance information system, product or operation management system, marketing information system, human resource information system. So these are all run over a single system, that is business intelligence system. So inside a business, under the business intelligence system, these are sorts of activities: accounting, finance, product, marketing, human resource. These are activities. They are getting service. They are getting service. So this is the enterprise resource planning system. So this is an ERP. So IAM also have one ERP. So where you are logging all this information. So there is also account information, student information, employee information, staff information. Every information is there. But where they are getting information? They are getting information from the transactions. Whatever the transaction, how a transaction happens, you are storing the information. Like I am giving, posting some inquiry or questions or material or assignments to the ERP. Now it is visible to all. Because how I am giving this information? By means of internet and by means of a laptop, by means of a hardware, by means of a software, something like that. So these are run, there is an IT infrastructure is running over there. Okay, so they are run, keep an eye of this, all the transactions, and from these activities, they are generate an ERP structure, and this ERP is creating a business intelligence system. Am I clear? Am I clear, students? Students, please respond. Am I clear?
Yes, sir.
Gaurav Tiwari.
Yes, sir.
Understood. Bhavesh.
Yes, sir.
Bhavesh.
Yes, sir.
Understood. If not understood, please ask me. I will explain again. Okay. Now, what happened? Nowadays, the shift in information system thinking. Why shifting happens? Let's see. System thinking often involves moving from observing events or data to identifying patterns of behavior over time. Like I'm giving a small example. How many of you are familiar about Colgate? How many of you are familiar about Colgate toothpaste? I'm talking about.
Yes, sir.
Anyone using?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So Colgate is a very old company. Colgate is a very old company. You people have also seen an advertisement from very old times. But nowadays, these advertisements are changing. Why? Can you anyone tell me why? Why they are not showing the same advertisement again and again and again for the continuous time? Why they are changing the advertisement?
Because they have products to be also updated to the current scenario of the needs of the customers.
Exactly. Anyone else? Any other answer? Any other answer? Why people are changing their advertisements? Colgate is a very old company. It is a toothpaste company. That time also it was a toothpaste. This time also it is a toothpaste. People are using the toothpaste only. But they are changing the advertisement. Why they are changing the advertisement? Why? Because the size and the content, the material, the requirement, everything get changed. Everything gets changed through by means of a time. 20 years back, people are also using the Colgate toothpaste. But 20 years later, also people are using the toothpaste. But the changing, the marketing strategy has been changed. The marketing audience also changed. Marketing strategy changed. Marketing audience is changed. So now, suppose consider at last 15 years back, very few people are using. Now the market size increases. So when the market size increases, they have to change the marketing strategy. So they are coming with the IDA certified, in dental institute of medical approved certified toothpaste. They are showing that this cavity is clear. With they are showing the Colgate white. Again, they are different product. Colgate white. They are coming with their mouthwasher also, Colgate mouthwasher. So the they are changing the thinking process. You cannot be, when you are doing business, you cannot be stick to a single objective. You have to be updated with the latest technology, latest information, because this is the trend. So that's why this shifting is happens. So in computer system, how it is happening now? The system thinking, like I can give you a small example. People were using Windows initially, Windows Service, Windows XP. Later on comes Windows Service Pack. Later on comes Windows operating system like Windows 8, then Windows 9, then Windows 10. Why? Why this Windows? Windows is an operating system. We can work in Windows 7 also. We can work in Windows 8 also. We can work in Windows 9 also. We can work in Windows 10 also. So what is the advantage of installing Windows 10 over Windows XP? Can anyone tell me? Every day you are using. Can anyone tell me why it is required? Not, I'm not saying essential. Why it is required to install Windows 10 over Windows XP? Any answer? Hey, every day you are using in your laptop, in your desktop. Your desktop is asking your updation. Why people are using? So
the software needs to be updated due according to the current needs. I mean, how the file requires how much space, only the current software will provide.
Yes, here you also using some mobile. And when your mobile is using, after a few days, mobile is asking your new update version is there. Will you interested to do? Again, it is asking a question. It is not updating, auto-updating. There is an option, auto-updation. If you have not clicked, it is asking a query to you. Windows update version is there. Android operating version is there. So now if you install your system softwares, which is installed over there, when applications, which is installed over there, is running smoothly, because there is an association of these things. You are installing when you are using Windows XP, you people are using Microsoft Office 2007 maybe, or 2003 maybe. Okay, now people are using 2015 2017 like theirs, because Windows is an operating system, so they are having their separate entities. So when you are installing Windows 10, your Microsoft Office 2003 might not work very properly. So you have to install Microsoft Office maybe 2013 onwards, so that you can work very efficiently. So that's why what I am saying here, you need to change a thinking. By means of a system. System thinking often involves moving from observing events or data to identifying patterns of behaviors over time, to surfacing the underlying structures that drive those events and patterns. So there is a pattern of change happens. It expands the range of choices available for solving a problem by broadening our thinking and helping us articulate the problems in new different way. When you are changing updation, you have to think like, okay, so tomorrow people are required these things. So I have to, like when I am teaching a new subject to you, I have to read these things. I have to collect the material in that way. I have to be successfully delivered to my students next day. So my thinking system has to be changed. Now, in SIFT, in information system thinking, what it is happening, it initiates and designs specific strategic information system. It incorporates the internet and electronic commerce into the business. It manages the system integration, including the internet, intranet, extranet. Everyone familiar? Intranet, intranet. Educating the non-MIS managers to about IT. Okay, so someone who is not understood about IT, so educating them people link. Okay. Educating the MIS staff about the business. So those who don't know the IEMCIP, people are educating them. You are okay, do these things, install this thing, give your ID, give your password, give your login information. So educating the MIS staff. Partnering the business unit executives. Managing outsourcing. Proactively using business and technical knowledge to seed innovative ideas about IT. And creating business alliance with business partners. So when you are doing the business, you are changing the thinking. Okay. Like when a car company is want to come with a new product, so they want to add some new features to their existing car. Okay, or else people will not buy the same car with the same things. So they are changing a different name, different version with some added functionalities. So that is a added system thinking is required. So I'm giving a top train in technology. Just see these things, and I will end this slide. Okay. So this is a video. Just let me know whether it is visible to you or not. I'm running the video. Is it visible, students?
Yes.
Is the video is visible?
So the video has not yet been played.
But okay, okay, okay. I'm sharing the video. Now it is visible. I hope it is visible now. Video is visible now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So I'm running that video. Just see and we'll discuss later on. Audio is coming? Students, audio is coming?
No, sir.
Okay. Just wait. Just let me know if it is working perfectly, then I'll proceed. Now it is coming?
Yes, sir, but the voice is not coming.
Okay.
So it is not audible.
So, coming to the slide, now slide is visible? Student, slide is visible?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, this video is nothing but the latest trends. Okay. So, what I am saying, I'll discuss these things in latest train in the next class. Okay. So I will suggest you to go through your IEM CRP, give your attendance, okay, and we will meet you in the next class and we will start with from here. Okay, it's already time over, so you go to their IEM CRP and give your attendance. Thank you.